Hi, I'm Presbytera Katie, and today I want to talk to you about the Prodigal Son. So, hi.
Hello.
I'm doing a video right now, so did you need anything?
I just came here to tell you that I'm leaving. I'm going far away.
Okay, is there a reason?
I just want to go have fun. I'm done with this place, and I want to be free.
Well, I'm sad to see you go. Do you know when you'll be back?
Hopefully never.
I'll help you get your things and, excuse me. Okay, well, I've got your bag. I guess we'll fill it up. You can be on your way.
Okay.
That's it. Are you sure you want to do this?
Yep.
We're going to miss you so much.
Can you go faster, please?
Wait, well, there's all the snacks you could ever want. Do you want to say bye to your brother?
Not really, but bye. Bye. I'll miss you. Yep.
Bye. I really hope Orange Jellyfish comes back, but I'm really glad you stayed with me. You have everything you need, all the snacks you could ever want, and a whole pantry full. Anyways, let's get back to talking about the Prodigal Son. The Prodigal Son is a parable that Jesus told in the Bible. It tells a story of a father and his two sons. The younger son one day approaches his father and asks for his inheritance so that he can leave. Now, an inheritance is usually a large sum of money that a child might inherit from their parents after they pass away. It's usually not something that you ask for before a parent passes away. In fact, it's pretty disrespectful to do so. But he did, and the father gave him his inheritance. He allowed his son to make that decision. He takes that money and he totally wastes it on things that don't even matter. And before long, he's left with nothing. He's sleeping with pigs. He's eating pig food. He sort of hits rock bottom and he realizes, wow, even my father's servants are treated better than this. And so he decided that he was going to return home and ask his father if he could be a servant. And what does the father do? Well, the father sees him coming down the road and... Wait a second. Hang on. Oh my goodness. Whoa. Is that? Oh my. My baby's back. I can't believe it. I'll have to tell your brother. Octi.
What is going on?
Your brother's home. Can you believe it?
So, I don't care. Big deal.
You should be happy. We thought he was dead.
Well, I'm not. So there.
Well, we are going to have a party, and we're going to get all the snacks out, and we're going to have a big, big celebration because we thought you were dead.
Well, I'm not coming. You never did anything for me. I've never had a party.
Octi, you were with me the whole time. You had everything that you needed.
Well, have fun without me because I'm not going.
So, what can we learn from this parable? Clearly, the main point is turning your repentance towards God's love. But I also think Jesus included the part about the older brother on purpose. If we, like the brother, have tried to live a good life, maybe we go to church every week or more than once a week, maybe we fast on fasting days, then we have no reason to be jealous or angry when we celebrate the repentance of others. The Bible says great rejoicing is done in heaven when even one person repents. It's not because they're more special or important than us, but because repentance is hard. Anytime someone turns away from sin and back towards God, it is like they've been given the greatest prize of all. Sometimes, like the older brother, we can be near to God, living a life of faith, and still get jealous, have a bad attitude or bad thoughts, and lose sight of why we do what we do. We can take God's love and grace for granted if we let pride seep into our minds and our hearts. So this parable really teaches us so much. One, we have a loving Father in heaven who desires for us to be with him. And two, whether we've gotten off track or allowed pride to seep into our minds and hearts, we can always repent and refocus. A party and a celebration is lovely, but it's not the prize. The prize is God's love and being close to him in his presence, now and for all eternity. I hope you've enjoyed today's video. I want to give a hand to Jalonzo, the octopus, and Chrysanthemum the jellyfish for their hard work today in the video. Thank you so much. Have a wonderful day.